And I came with another title here, Healthy You, because we are doing the Young People's Meeting today, and many times when we are talking about health, who is concerned about health more?
The sick people.
The sick people. And who are the sick people? 16 years old? 17 years old? 20? So sometimes just the old people are concerned about health.
From 38 up, we have
from 38 up, and it's interesting because we have different experiences, like inviting people to cooking classes, inviting people to health seminars, and only the old people would show interest into that. So why do we need to study even about being young to study about health? And it says that in Child's Guidance, page 103, paragraph 3 says that the first study of the young should be to know themselves and how to keep their bodies in health. So this should be the first study of the young, to know themselves and how to keep their bodies in health. Why? Because every decision we take, they have an effect upon our health. And if our health is wrong, it will have an effect upon our character and then upon our eternal destiny. And as I mentioned already, that people who show more interest in the health lifestyle, there are those who already experienced sickness. But how did they get sick at that time? Just suddenly? It is because they didn't preserve their health while they were young. And God blessed us with these bodies, and we are supposed to preserve the health. We are supposed to take care of this health. And in December, I visited someone at the hospital, and I was informed that the person that I visited was sick, and she was about to die, pass away. And when I went there, I saw that probably she is about 50, 60 years old. And I've been talking with the husband, and I tried to encourage them a little bit. And after a week, I found out that she passed away, and I asked how old was she. And they told me 35 years old. And then I tried to understand why did she look so old. And because of her lifestyle. She used to drink, she used to not take care of herself, like even about the food that she ate, we called it junk food. And she got to the age of 35 years old when I thought that she is much more older. So that's why it is important to study about health from early years. And the topic that I'm going to present today is something that I think old and young, each one of us has to deal with. How many of you does not have a cell phone? Okay, we have here a sister that she doesn't have. But you have an iPad, so it's still technology. How many of you use computers for their own work? We need to study, we need to work, we need to use the computers. So, as I mentioned, young and old, we have to use this. And Daniel, the prophet Daniel, in Daniel chapter 12, he prophesied that in the time of end, he said that the knowledge shall be increased. And that's true. The technology is something that came as a fulfillment of this prophecy, that they never had technology in those times. But every blessing that comes even with some good characteristics and even with some evil in it. And I was thinking, why do we need to have computers? It's wonderful to have computers, to be able to store everything there. And all the machineries that we have, they are for our beneficial. But why do we need to have these computers today? The people in old times, they didn't need this because they had strength, they had power, and all the things that we were studying about Moses and his leadership. And do you remember what the people of Israel were doing while they were in Egyptian captivity there? They were building. And they didn't have excavators or throughout the years, we got to the point where we were too weak to use our bodies, and then we needed something to boom a cell phone, we would get even nightmares. And we all use our cell phone, and we put it close to us that in the morning or whenever we wake up to check the time. But it is something that when they were able to feel the times again, there was a person there, a guy that he was working at the airport. He noticed that the pilots are not there, and he stopped the plane. So he stopped, he took off without permission, and the authorities tried to make him come back. And he said, oh, I'm just enjoying my flight at this time. And they asked him, are you a pilot? And he said, no, but I've been playing all the video games about, he mentioned the video game in the plane. And so what's a danger into playing these video games and watching these movies? As I mentioned, God didn't create our brains to face, to deal with these things. And when we deal with these things, our brain does not make any difference between what is real and what is unreal. And that person, he was playing, he was a good player, and now he found himself stealing that aircraft, and because he went out of gas, he, out of fuel, he crashed. And sometimes we can find our end just seeing illusions and taking decisions upon them. And I had another experience while in Romania. I was visiting a older person, a lady, and she had her granddaughter with her. And the granddaughter, she was about 5 years old, and they had a TV watching one news. And one day, the granddaughter came to the grandmother and she asked, but when we are going to beat someone, when we are going to kill someone, because this is what they were seeing at the TV. And they thought, the brains already cannot make any difference in what is good and what is not good, and what is real and what is unreal. So technology is a blessing, but at the same time can affect our brain health. And the second one is the physical health. And you have here a picture, and I don't have to comment upon this because you already see some defects there. So the first one is, he has a glasses, he's wearing glasses, and I just got my glasses 2 weeks ago, and the doctor said that since we got the technology, their business just increased. Because there is too much light going into our eyes that is damaging. And then another defect is his posture. And about the eyes, health can improve, but it's not much hope. But about the posture, you can still work out, fix it, but spending like 10 years just working on your computer, now it will take a long time to be in a better shape. The habit of sitting up late at night is customary, but it is not pleasing to God. Even if you are both Christians, this antibody hours of during health unfill the mind for the next day's duties and have an appearance of evil. So sometimes I use computer a lot because I do everything that all kind of good work and the studies, but sometimes I notice myself working during the night time. And in the morning I could see my eyes were like red. And when I went to do the eye exam, they told me that this late night working times, working hours, they affected me. So you spend a night or so, and then when you realize that you cannot see clear anymore. And David that I will behave myself wisely in a perfect way. Come, when will thou come unto me? I will walk with thee in my house with a perfect heart. And to have a perfect heart, I mentioned that technology is affecting the mind health, and as well the heart health. And to have a perfect heart, David said that I will set no wicked thing before my eyes. But we have the technology through which gate of our souls the technology goes to our minds, through the eyes. So David said that I will set no wicked thing before my eyes. I hate the work of them that turn aside, it shall not cleave to me. All unnecessary tasks that we do. We have this social media. Let us ask ourselves, do I really need it? Why do I use it for? If I use it just to kill time, then remove it. If you are using it for some benefits, then keep it, but reduce the time that you are using it. So the first will be to remove all unnecessary apps, then get it from some an eye exam. It's good to make sure that you to know where you are and not to damage your sight more than is it. Then use proper lighting. I mentioned about working nights. And even sometimes you cannot avoid that. Sometimes we get late home and we need to finish some scores. Use proper lighting. Then upgrade your display. Sometimes I notice myself, and even reading a book, in the morning I would have the book on the table, but as I was continuing reading, I would just close the book towards my eyes. And the same happened even with the computer. So in order to preserve your health a little bit, it's better to find a bigger display or some newer display in order to let the technology always try to upgrade into a health benefit. So get a better display that you might not damage your eyes more. Adjust your computer display settings. We know that we have the brightness there, we have the face size, and the color temperature. And whenever you feel that your eyes does not match those tasks there, you should work on them. You should set them better. Then blink more often. He said that while we are watching TVs or computers, everything, instead of blinking as usually, we blink just one third. So instead of doing as we are supposed to, we don't do neither half of the time we need. Exercise your eyes. So this is about, sometimes I find myself working even about 6-7 hours on a computer. So at this time it's good to, after 20 minutes, to take your eyes from the screen and try to relax them a little bit for a few seconds. Then take frequent breaks. These breaks, I don't know how your time is, how your schedule is, but it's good to take some breaks at least every 30 minutes for a few minutes, just to break. Modify your workstation. If sometimes I met people that they were doing like proofreading, or they would have to copyright things, they had to, or copy-paste things, they had to have the paper or the book and to type on the computer. So at least to be, I don't know if you do this, this work, but if you do it, try to uplift somehow your paper that your eyes won't go from one place to another so consecutively. Consider computer glasses, and there are some computer glasses only for protection, to block the blue light that is coming to your eyes. And as I asked in the beginning about the young people and a healthy lifestyle. Cesar Gavila read it already in 1 Corinthians. chapter 6, they said that knowing now that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost, which is in you, which ye have of God, and ye are not your own, God gave us